Thanks for joining us here on the web. Kevin Paul is headed back to prison. He was on parole after serving time for witnessing the killing of Epsom police officer Jeremy Sharon. He was recently arrested in Massachusetts on new charges. Today, the parole board made the decision to send him back behind bars. Paul was with Gordon Perry in 1997 when Perry murdered Epsom police officer Jeremy Sharon. Paul pleaded guilty to several charges that included shooting at police officers as the two tried to make their getaway. Perry is serving life in prison. Paul was sentenced to 16 to 50 years in prison. He was granted parole in May, but last month authorities picked him up on several violations that include new criminal charges. Prosecutors say the parole board has given Paul chances in the past and call this an or else day for Paul.
It's clear that you can't take him at his word. His words mean nothing, and quite frankly, it appears that he thinks your words mean nothing. If you're gonna say zero tolerance, with all due respect, it's gotta be zero tolerance. Today is the or else day you keep telling this defendant.
Paul is still facing new criminal charges that include firearm offenses. Those have been bound over to the Superior Court. Granite Staters view it as the number one problem in New Hampshire, and those charged with doing something about substance abuse are meeting in Concord. The Joint Legislative Task Force on the Heroin and Opioid Epidemic is considering a number of different bills and will begin voting on what ideas to fast track later this afternoon. Ray Brewer has more.
With votes looming, the Joint Legislative Task Force on Opioid Abuse heard one last morning of testimony. The lead-off witness, the head of state police, who said law enforcement is trying new tactics to deal with the problem, such as a mobile enforcement team.
In 9 weeks, they've made 59 arrests. They've written 5 search warrants. They have 45 of those 59 were felony drug arrests, and again, they've seized quite a bit of illicit drugs.
The colonel has said, though, law enforcement can't do it alone. And towards that end, the task force heard about a diversion program designed to keep people out of the criminal justice system. The director says education is the key.
We see anywhere from 800 to 900 people a year in all of our programs, and that's because law enforcement understands addiction here in Merrimack County and understands that not everybody that's addicted wants to be addicted.
Legislators say they're aware that substance abuse is a chronic problem. One healthcare provider says coordination is sometimes lacking. A more holistic approach is needed.
What are the assets of each respective system, and trying to figure out how to get the best of all those assets aligned in the best way to address the whole epidemic.
The task force is also considering new initiatives, such as a proposal by firefighters to provide drug and alcohol training to paramedics and hopefully get people on the road to recovery.
And that was Ray Brewer reporting. To Salem now, where police say they have just arrested a man for breaking into a dozen vehicles. Henry Schumann is facing 12 counts of theft by unauthorized taking after officers were called to the Westgate Arms apartment complex and discovered a man matching the description they were given. Officers say they located 12 victims, and Schumann was given a January court date. And happening now, Manchester police are investigating 2 armed robberies, including one where the suspect jumped over the counter. That happened at Shaw's Corner Market just before 9 last night. Police say this man was armed with a knife when he got into a physical confrontation with the clerk while ordering him to open the register. He was able to get some cash before leaving. Hours later, the 7-Eleven on Queen City Avenue was targeted. The suspect demanded the clerk open the register. Instead, she grabbed her phone and locked herself inside the office. The suspect left without any cash or merchandise. Starting tonight at 5, customers of one utility are paying less money this winter. Who's dropping prices by 5%? And this was no accident. What made this man so angry? He drove straight into a hotel. That does it for us here on the web. Thanks for joining us. Have a great afternoon.